Hi, Tammy C. Walker here, life coach, therapist, social worker. Hit subscribe and hit like. Also, tap the bell where you can get notifications of my latest and greatest videos. Today's video is about how people pleasers need to learn the word no. People pleasers are people that go around and say yes to invitations, to events, to jobs, to volunteering. I mean, it's simply things they don't want to do, but they feel that need to say yes because they don't want to be not liked. It's something deeper than just wanting to make others happy. It's something deeper that's within us that makes us feel the need to always say yes. At the end of the day, we're making ourselves miserable with these constant yeses when we know deep in our heart we want to say no. And for some people, we want to say, hell no. And it's actually okay. Look, we only have 24 hours in a day. And many of us work 9 to 5s. We're therapists, life coaches, teachers, hey, blue collar workers, white collar workers, parents, aunties. We have to take care of our own health. It's a lot going on. So to keep saying yes to all of these things, it's really burning a hole in your own health and your time. So it's okay to say no, and you don't have to be mean about it, but be deliberate and firm. See, a people pleaser, they're so concerned with people liking them and people not being mad with them that they're not understanding that people are already mad anyway. And we have to remember that people are also selfish. So some of the time you're thinking they're mad at you, you're not even on their radar. You're not even on their mind because they're so engulfed in their own thing. So learn to say no. Back in 1995, I would go to bridal showers, baby showers, kids' parties, and I don't even have kids. To this day, I don't have kids, but I would go because I attended this church. It was a big church. A lot of people had kids. They were getting married, and I wanted to kind of fit in, but I had to learn Tammy C. Walker don't never fit in because she don't want to fit in because I beat my drum to my own beat. And I always say I'm a weirdo or I'm different, but I had to learn, aha, there's nothing wrong with that. It's good to be your own person. You don't want to fit in. You want to start a trend. You want to be a leader, not a follower. And it's okay to say no. Look, it's summertime. I live outside of Chicago. And I've been invited to a 50th anniversary party, which I did attend. My high school that I attended, they always have events each summer. I can't go. I've been invited to a birthday party, a wedding, a bridal shower. My niece just graduated last Friday. I had to go. That's my niece. So these are just some events that I've been invited to in June and July. We haven't even hit August and September. And September is my birthday month. I want to do some nice things for me. It's only so many warm days here in Chicago. I like to play tennis. I like to go for long walks. I want to capitalize on those nice weather days. I can't say yes to every invitation. And it's okay. You can do it politely. Sometimes if you can't make all of these events, a nice car and a put some money in the car and give it to them. And that's just as sufficient. Don't burn yourself out people pleasing. You will regret it. And a lot of times you resent going to all of these events. You resent that you said yes. And you want to be liked or accepted. You don't want people to be mad at you. Sometimes people are mad at you for no reason. They're mad because you're fat. They're mad because you're skinny. They're mad because your eye is big. They're mad because you have short hair. They have long hair. And they wanted curly hair. And you have straight hair. People get mad over the darnest things, and you just can't worry about it. Just please yourself. Be kind and loving to others, but don't people please. It doesn't look good. People don't respect you, and you're going to be miserable with yourself because you're not being true to yourself. I remember having chemo. A lot of people don't know what chemo is, which I was shocked. They take a needle, put it into your vein, and pump. For me, it was 3 hours worth of 3 different types of poison in my system and chemo medicine that shrunk the tumor. I had breast cancer. I was very, very, very ill. And my phone would be ringing, ringing, ringing. I have a lot of friends, and I went to a big church, and I had all these people checking on me, and I'm a very blessed person. But I was so ill, it was no way I could answer my phone. I was too sick to pick up the phone. After I would get administered the chemo, I would have to take a shot called Neulasta. They have commercials on it. And because I was so young, 36, and I had a good body, I didn't need that shot to revamp my white blood cells. Maybe like a 60 or 70 year old would need. But for some reason, this wasn't discovered, but I discovered it for myself. I became so sick after that shot, like cramps in my neck. I could barely lift my limbs. It was to the point where I was laying on the pillow in my bed, and I couldn't lift my head off the pillow. So my phone would be ringing, but I couldn't answer. And people would say, I called you. And I'm like, I'm so sick, I couldn't pick up the phone. It's like people didn't even understand what I was saying, but I didn't care. I was fighting for my life. I appreciated every call, every text, everybody that brought me money, gifts, anything. I did not take it for granted, but I was so sick, I had to take care of myself. I just couldn't return phone calls, and it was okay. Look, if people don't understand when you're sick and you can't call them back, if they don't understand you're going through a divorce, you can't get back to them. They don't understand you just got let go from a job. You're taking care of yourself. Sometimes we have to question some of these friends and family members. We don't want people in our lives that don't support us, that don't rally around us when we're in a low place. Sometimes people just need a break. And that's the gospel truth. And when people take a break, we get mad. I'm going to be transparent with you. I don't like to talk about my personal life, but I'm on YouTube. I was in a long-term relationship, and recently we're not together, and I'm devastated, and was devastated, still very upset. But my ex-guy, he just was overwhelmed with a lot of stuff, sick parents, kids in college, a job he hate, this, that, like all these things coming at him. And maybe it was too much for him. As pissed off as I am or as hurt, I understand it at the same time. He just can't. And we can't get mad with people when they choose themselves. That's all. We can't get mad because I had to choose myself. It was sometimes I couldn't with a lot of people. I just couldn't. Choose you. Don't people please. Don't people please. You'll feel better about yourself. So get your speech together. Hey, you want to come to this wedding? Hey, can you watch my kids? Get your speech together. No, with all due respect, I'm busy. No, I won't be attending that, but thank you for the invite. Get ready for it. It's coming. Tammy C. Walker, life coach, therapist, social worker. My channel is starting to grow. So hit like, hit subscribe, maybe send some people my way. Basically, I'm a life coach, therapist, social worker, but I talk about everything. I'm a breast cancer survivor, so I can do videos on relationships, on surviving cancer, on being happy, on being depressed. So many topics, seriously. So leave some comments and keep watching and say no, hell no to some people. But you all know what I mean. If you do want a life coaching session, I am on Skype and I can do this via phone. $30 for 30 minutes. TWalker@dreamsareareality.com is my email. Thank you for watching. Seriously, I always want to give nothing but the best to everyone. Thank you. Bye.